Still can't quite see where I'm supposed to land this thing. Hello again, everyone. Today I'm flying Ultralight. I purchased the 103 Solo Ultralight from Top Rudder Aircraft. It's a completely open cockpit. The instruments are minimal. Basically, you kind of just have to do everything by the seat of your pants. Nothing to keep the wind out of your face. It's just all open. In fact, I'm having to keep the brakes on because it wants to roll backwards. I flew this once before and I found it super difficult to fly, and I think that's because you're going so fast you just don't have a lot of authority over the control surfaces. But anyway, let's give this a try. I'm going to go ahead and let off the brake and start giving it some throttle. Don't know exactly when it's okay to lift off, but we'll find out. I'm going to give it some more throttle. Probably a good idea to get going pretty fast. Alright, let's start lifting up a little bit, see if we can take off. Okay, so we're airborne. It doesn't get a lot of lift, so I'm going to be very careful not to take off too quickly. Just try to gain altitude. Okay, this is already much better than the first flight. The first time around, it was a crazy, almost stalling mess all over the airport. Let's see what this looks like from the outside. Alright, well, it gives a better sense of my ascent angle. Let's go back inside. It's all open, so you're hearing the engine and everything. Let's look around. Again, you know, minimal instrumentation, so pretty much just telling you about the engine, and I think it does have an airspeed sensor. Alright, well, it's not so bad. It's going very slow. That's fine. That's what you would expect in an ultralight. I drive by this airport all the time, but I've never actually been here in person. I should come here sometime just for fun. I live nearby, of course. Maybe I can try to find my house. But so far the flight seems to be successful. You can only gain altitude a little bit at a time, but I do feel like I'm gaining some altitude. I see jet fighter on the tarmac.
Hey, Swap 5, continue for east departure. I will contact you next when you leave my airspace.
Concord Tower KA-445, continue for east departure.
So you really just kind of have to feel your angle, your acceleration angle. Maybe I could take some cues from the horizon and in front of the aircraft. I really don't know at what point I'll start stalling. It seemed super easy to stall the last time. Set a destination of a little landing strip in a fruit farm somewhere. Let's see if I can fly and do all this at the same time. Of course, there's no autopilot, so I'm not going to be able to just let it take over. This is actually kind of fun. I could see this being a lot of fun to do in person if you have the skills for it. It obviously seems terribly dangerous, but still I think it could be a lot of fun. So here we are flying over the Concord area. I live in Pittsburgh, which is just over that hill a bit ahead of us. That's the Highway 4. think this area over here is actually a ammo repository or something. Maybe I can get a lower angle and kind of take a better look. I know there's a Concord Naval Weapons Depot nearby. We're going a bit fast. Pull back on the throttle just a bit. So I think they're using this area to store old munitions. Water looks really pretty. I doubt it really looks like that in person. Yeah, so after my fiasco the first time trying to fly this, this actually feels very doable. Really not having much trouble at all. There's a large yellow section on the speed, and so I assume if I go into the yellow it's okay, just don't stay there. Yeah, so this is the area that looks especially like it's a munitions dump or something. I wouldn't typically expect to see cars driving through here, but, you know, the game doesn't know any better. I'm a little afraid of losing too much altitude. I think I will throttle up, try to climb a bit. I don't think I necessarily want to try to climb right over these hills. I'm not sure the aircraft could do that, but I can head over towards the freeway. Let's see, how much can I safely throttle this thing up? I mean, maybe I'm underestimating the plane. It seems to be doing an okay job climbing, actually. Throttle because I think we've climbed enough at the 50% point. Yeah, this feels very comfortable to fly, actually. I just had to kind of mentally adjust to everything being slower and having less authority. Yeah, I can see this being a lot of fun. I suppose this is something you build in your garage from a kit.
Concord Tower KA-445 frequency change. Travis approach KA-445.
I do see a little tiny green line on the airspeed indicator. I guess that's my stall speed, so that helps to fly from inside. Okay, so like I said, this is the Highway 4 that goes through Contra Costa County. Doesn't exactly look like that. You don't have cars crossing on the surface and disappearing underneath, or whatever, but that's okay. bunch of new construction on the right, although it looks kind of trashed. But it doesn't look trashed in real life. Wow, the water looks amazing. It doesn't look like that in real life either. It's probably just a little trickle. And then, you know, you don't have cars driving back and forth through it like that. Very strange. I'm gonna give it some more throttle and try to get some more altitude. Oh, I was about to stall. I don't seem to be able to reset the external view to be square. Let's see if I can do that with the mouse. Okay. Alright, there's the BART station. And the supermarket I go to is right here. See if I can see if the photogrammetry logo is in place. I'll have to swing around. I feel like I'm getting the hang of flying this. Just have to keep an eye on my airspeed and I should be okay. That's usually the case always when flying. Okay, couldn't really see the logo. I could try to go back and look at it again. Drop the throttle down, slow down a bit, head back over there. Okay, I'm about to stall again, so let's nose down. Some on throttle. Okay, here we are. Like we're nose diving into Safeway. But yeah, that's the store. Photogrammetry data looks super awful, but it's better than not having it, having everything look generic. Okay, more throttle, we're starting to lose airspeed, don't want to fall out of the sky. I'm trying to keep an eye on that little green line on the airspeed indicator, tiny, itty-bitty little green line. See if I can look for signs of my neighborhood. There's this interesting swath carved right through this area, and it's something like the Delta Trail or something. It's interesting that it looks like it's almost carved out to make a freeway eventually or something. But I might be able to fly by my place using this as a reference. Maybe, although I don't really recognize any of this right here. Like a bunch of solar panels and a college, maybe of some kind. having trouble locking into any what am I looking for? I don't know. Area references. Landmarks. But that Delta Trail just carves all the way through. Again, doesn't look like it. Not sure what this big complex over here is. Probably a school. Yep, looks like a school. Alright, this plane's feeling pretty maneuverable, pretty controllable. I'm enjoying this. Doesn't seem to be having a lot of trouble. As long as I keep an eye on my airspeed. You know, there's no stall warning alarms or anything like that. It's all up to me to make sure I'm doing this right. Still trying to see if I can find any recognizable landmarks. I fly through here. All looks vaguely familiar. Looks like there's this beautiful filled canal going all the way through. I don't think that's the case. I mean, there is some kind of a canal, but I don't know if it's quite that pretty looking. Again, the external camera wants to be off to one side. See if I can dial that in. Okay. Okay, so I have seen some landmarks over here. I might have found something. I think this is the local little mini shopping center with the DMV and some other things in it. Okay, well, so I live in this general area. I'm not going to try to actually spot my house. Alright, well, let's keep going, and I'm going to see if I can land at that airport in Byron. That, actually, is it in Byron? Anyway, it's the little landing strip on a fruit farm. Probably be a while before we actually get there. I wonder if I can go faster if I throttle up. Let's push it a little bit, see what we can do. But I have to say this feels eminently flyable after the first time when it felt like I couldn't get it off the ground at all. Yeah, that's funny, those views are skewed. See that engine? Oh, there were feet there. The feet disappear if you get close enough.
4 Charlie Alpha 2, traffic KA-445, 10 miles west, 200 feet inbound to land, runway 3.
Alright, well let me go back inside, just make sure that I'm doing all this stuff right. So it's funny, it's a single airplane. It's a, you know, solo seat airplane, but my co-pilot just radioed the tower, or at least announced our intention to land. So we have some sort of a phantom AI co-pilot. It's going to be a while before we actually get to the landing pad. Maybe I should try to get a little bit of altitude. See what we can do in that respect. Guessing the brackets are going to say we're going too slow, but not for this aircraft. Alright, so I want to try to gain some airspeed now that I've got some altitude. Funny that the on-screen controls are also very primitive compared to the other planes. Something nice about that though. Yeah, we still have a ways to go before we actually get here. I'm not sure what kind of instruments are required to be in an ultralight. This just has, you know, again, the very bare minimum. Basically, engine and airspeed. Okay, let me see if I can get this speed up some more. I have the engine into the yellow, I'm going to pull it back a little bit. This seems to be about as fast as I'm going to be able to go. kind of funny, the pilot, I think, is not wearing a helmet or anything, so you'd be getting bugs in your teeth and in your eyes and whatever. Flying this without some kind of a motorcycle helmet, like a face shield or something. Before about airspeed, but then I realized, I mean, in terms of going too fast, but then I realized that that yellow range is so wide that it's probably fine to not worry about it until it gets into the red. I have no idea what it's going to be like landing on this little dirt strip. I'm not even sure there's any dirt, it may just be grass. Nice that there's a 12-volt lighter socket there. I guess if you had to plug in a USB charger or something. I almost feel like I should just dispense with the landing pattern per se and just head towards the smallest bracket. Throwing out the different views. Oh, that's an interesting view, standing up. I don't know why it doesn't want to center. Okay, well, it's sort of close, I guess. Seems like it varies a lot, though. Hard to maintain this view and stare the plane at the same time, but I wanted to see what this school looked like. A lot of tennis courts. I don't suppose there's any kind of flaps or anything like that. Of course not. What happens if I hit autopilot? Nothing. Okay, that's right. Makes sense. Hitting buttons on my Logitech switch panels. Alright, well, at least the view is forward when you're inside. I'm gonna pull back on the throttle a little bit, start slowing it down. Feels very comfortable flying this. I'm just a little bit surprised. Okay, more lowering of the throttle. Descending quite a bit now, so we can use that to keep us going. Probably gonna have to give it some more throttle though before I land. kind of nose up just a bit, get a little bit of altitude out if I can. It actually does say too fast, so it is adjusted to the plane. The plane slows down really easily, so I'm not too worried about that. I don't know if it is that green line that's my stall indicator. Maybe it's the 30. Maybe it's at 30. So I probably could afford to go a little slower. I still say too fast. I could slow down by nosing up. Not too much. Alright, so I want this to go below 40. Have an eye on the runway itself yet. Throttling, we're descending quite a bit now. Still can't quite see where I'm supposed to land this thing. Drop it down in the field. Okay, throttle all the way down. And let's just glide for a while. Maybe I can find an area that doesn't have vegetation in it. Very stable. Let's give it a bit more throttle. It didn't really like that. I don't think it likes thrusting on very much. I just really could not tell where I was supposed to land. Okay, we're coming in too fast. This is probably going to be a little bit crashy. Maybe. Let's see. How is this? Bounced a little bit. That didn't seem too bad. Alright, let's see. Can I turn the engine off? Actually, what happens if I do it from... Oh, no. I have to do it from my Logitech panel, but it's already off there. That turns it off. And that's it. Thank you for watching my silly ultralight flight from Concord to Funny Farms. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.